Okay. And it looks like I forgot to do one other thing. Now, this is gonna be quite risky here. If I do this, I'm not gonna be able to export the video on YouTube, export the video to YouTube. This will probably take a few minutes. What I'm gonna do is, let me log on to that. I'm changing my Twitch description right now. Okay, there we go. But what I'm also gonna do, I think I have the music. I think I've got what little music that's actually in the game turned off. I'm gonna replace it with a Dungeon Master. For the Super Nintendo, I've got that soundtrack going. But like I said, I'm gonna try anyway. But after I make this stream fed, I'm gonna try to export it to YouTube. If it gets flagged for copyright, I'm gonna have to delete it. I'm gonna check the volume level real quick. Well, that's way too loud. Right now, this is just a sound test. But, just let me know if this is too quiet or too loud for you. I'm gonna go ahead and I'll get started. And I'm gonna start a new game. I had one going for a while, but I got stuck at a certain part, like, I don't know, like four or six, something like that. Oh, and I'll also be eating peanut butter and crackers as well. Come on. I forgot what you put the points into. Was it a dexterity? I can't remember. Oh, what was it? you're supposed to put someone off. I'll do that to at least balance it out. Guess it goes in there. And same thing here. This one here is a mage. And I think you want spellcraft to, I believe, at least two. So they can use the light spell. I can't really remember. I guess that one. I can't think of anything else. Okay, now there's a... The way this is supposed to work... One guy suggested that, I'm going the unarmed combat route with one of my back row guys. I gotta get assassination in there and I gotta get 12 points in it. The problem with that is it looks like you have to split between unarmed and assassination, so won't be that. Sound right. I'm really hoping it's because of my headphones. last time. Omega mob. Throwing weapons. I believe, thrown weapons are determined by your, strength. Okay, so I think that's everything. Off we go. Ambient turned off. Turn this up a little bit. These guys gotta fight unarmed. Big fan of this, but Number four guy is also gonna be my food bearer. Oh, this one. I gotta find two blue gems and put in that. Put in that. Face's eye sockets. Also, I do use cheats on here as well, but the only one I'm going to be using is the party heal one. Reason being is, there is no, in this game here, you can only save at save crystals, and they're used very sparingly. You can't, there is no quick saving in this game. And, if there was, then I wouldn't be using cheats at all. So, but of all the cheats you can use, none of them involve, like, creating a save crystal or anything like that. So, this is my alternative, the party heal cheat. But, for the most part, it's going to be the only one I'm going to be using. Thank you. Insectoids, they don't use as much food, so I can feed him last. Fireburst, I already know that one. I thought there was supposed to be a blue gem in here somewhere. Oh, I'm guessing it's in here. There it is. Did I already get these?
fine.
Need a lot of room for this guy. Oh, yeah, I forgot about this, too. Something else I learned recently. Legionary shields grant evasion. It seems kind of weird and counterintuitive because these guys aren't on fighters. But unless I'm wrong, as long as one hand is free to attack with, it's still considered unarmed. Those scrolls really aren't worth looking at. You know, with all these torches I keep picking up, I don't really need to get this to level 5 for the light spell. I think it was this. Nope. still thinking. Guess I could check and make sure my app's actually working. I had to restart it as well. Okay, it works. I don't remember what I was wanting to do. Oh, and I remember these. They shoot, these guys coming up shoot AoE poison. It, like, damages everybody in your party. Compass that I'll probably never use. Key that I most certainly will. All jerky. And nobody in my group uses swords, so... Thank you. Oh, and this this song here was never actually added to the game. It was just one of those that didn't make the cut. Oh yeah, this. Can't hit shit. And because I can't think of anything else to play, I'm gonna go and start the playlist over. Oh, I think I remember this. Yeah. I think you have to fight all three of these. You gotta kill them quick, too. Thank you. pick up another shield, give it to him. No idea what that does. Okay, there we go. Ah, those ones. Okay, if I remember this one correctly, you gotta push the right buttons in the right combination. Exactly what that combination is, I have no idea. Like I said, I have no idea what combination of buttons I'm supposed to push. And apparently it wasn't that. That sack, man, sack, you're definitely want to hold on to that. Yeah, they're missing like crazy. Need a key to get in there. Yeah, how's that one? There it is. Don't need that. On you go. That I do. Apparently I gotta find more than one. You know, I'll tell you what. Close that real quick. Let me pause the music real quick. Now that I'm at a good stopping point right now, I'm gonna go ahead and break off of this game, and I'm gonna go ahead and try designing one of my own levels. I've done this before. I've experimented with it a little bit, but not to this extent. So let me go ahead and I guess I should probably check and make sure that it actually shows up. Yeah, it does. So let's go to file. Okay, and on this time. guess we got that. Okay. So you can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna go to here. New project. Let's type down Joe's. Start with a simple 10x10. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, we got ourselves a big ol' 10x10 area. Okay, I see what I did. Let me move back over. Yeah, so I can't really do it like that. I totally forgot. Okay, now let me preview it. Okay, there we go. So now we'll put a door. Put a door like that. Just a little bit. Go back to wall mode. that. So let's go over here. Items. Actually, you want a torch? Actually, no, that's incorrect. I don't know the name of it. Not that, torch holder or something like that. Maybe it's a prop. Yeah, that's it, torch holder. Back of wall mode. So now to get my gears going. Okay, let's see. No. So I'm gonna have to redo that. Oh, okay.
Die.
Okay, so let's look that over again. There we go. Let there be light. Yeah. On the wall. Text. That's what I'm looking for. Let me think of something. Okay, now let me check and make sure it took. Okay, when I did my first dungeon earlier, or some time ago, I used dice rolls for it. I'll kind of show you what I mean here. So we'll go over here. Go to Google. Go ahead and erase those two. so what I... I guess I'll introduce you to what I've got going on here. If you can see that, what I'm gonna do is for the four-sided dice is gonna be for the four cardinal directions. Up, I think one is up, two is right, three is down, four is left. And I'm gonna use the six-sided dice for the amount of spaces that it's going to travel in. Now, there's going to be, it's not carved in stone, so there's going to be some judgment calls you're going to have to make. You know, actually, I kind of wish, you know, I do have this kind of dice in real life. Problem is I'd have to go dig it up. I have no idea where they are. It's a little burgundy bag full of dice. But anyway, this is how I'm gonna do it, though. So, we'll get started. Okay. Well, before then... Okay, let's preview it, make sure it actually works. Alright, let's try it now. Ta-da! Okay, now, shall we begin? And here is where I'm gonna start doing the dice rolling. Okay, down. Four spaces. Two, three, four. Left. Six spaces. One. So right, another six spaces, one, two, three, four, five, six, so I'm at the corner. Left. Okay, I'm discarding that one. Right, four spaces, one, two. One. Left. Three spaces. No. Discarding that one. Right. Four spaces. Down. Six spaces. But like I said, some of these rolls I'm gonna be discarding because they just weren't gonna work out for some reason. But yeah, this is just my way of saying I have no imagination whatsoever. I could conceive of something concrete, but The nature of a dungeon, to me, the most accurate or the most consistent look is gonna be prisons, you know, like cells. Maybe like places where they do underground satanic rituals or something. They're probably gonna have some kind of order and structure to the way they do stuff, but really there's not that many options to work with. for me to really stretch out imagination-wise, I'd have to purchase Legend of Grimrock too, because you can make outdoor stuff on there as well. Getting back to here though. Left. 5 spaces. But my understanding of the way of how dungeons are created, they're almost created the same way railroad tracks are made. You want them on the path of least resistance. So you're not gonna see train tracks go straight from point A to point B. I mean, if there's mountains on the way, that's just gonna kill any trains that try to pass or see. They're gonna try to snake around, try to take the low flat road and whatnot. You know, they're not just gonna go straight up 10,000 feet on top of the mountain and straight down 10,000. I mean, it doesn't work that way. You know, they're gonna take the most simplest route. These dungeons are supposed to work the same way too. So I'm trying to kind of simulate that. Oh. Two. Right. Three. Down. Two. Oh. Discarding that. Down. One. Actually, I'm discarding that other one. Six. Right, three. One, two, three. Up, five. Discarding that. To say it has to be right, but this time I'm only rolling a 4-sided dice on it though. Four. Now it sounds almost like Soul Blazer music. Right. Six. Left, three. One, two, three. It's got to be either one or three. Up, four. I'm just gonna stay there. I totally forgot which one of these I was supposed to. And it was up four. One, two, three, four. Left, one. Down, four. down. 4. Right? 4. Down. 5. Okay, I'm at the limit. It's gotta be either 2 or 4. Right? 4. Right, 6. Only up is possible. Or no. Yeah, for right now, only up. 2 spaces. Either left or up. I'm going up. 4 spaces. Same thing, only up or left. So it's either 1 or 4. Or left. 5. Okay, so since this is going to be a level 1, I'm just going to go ahead and call it good on that. So then the next question. I'm gonna go ahead and put the stairs down over here. Again, this is only level 1. Only level 1, so there's really not much point in putting a door right here or anything. And again, we're right now what I'm envisioning with this is just people, you know, just people trying to mine down, just mining their way down to the bottom of whatever, wherever it is they're trying to go, taking the path of least resistance. So there's gonna be nothing orderly about these dungeons. Like I said, these are all RNG. So I guess I can go ahead and And also, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna kill the music at least temporarily. Oh, no. And another thing, I'm trying to add some organicness to these dungeons. So yes, there's gonna be a lot of dead ends. They're there for no reason. Yes, theoretically, if you've run this dungeon before, you can go from point A straight to point B, head down, heading to the stairs down to the next level. I mean, yes, you can do that, or if it's your very first time running these, you're probably going to go all over the place trying to explore every nook and cranny, trying to find something. There's going to be a lot of dry humps in here. There's going to be a lot of fruitless searches. But basically, I'm trying to avoid using a Skinner box. That's what it's called. Hard to explain what a Skinner box is. It's like conducting experiments like on rabbits. You know, you put a rabbit in a maze, inside of a maze, and you have to, you know, flip switches that pull lights. I mean, the game itself, you know, Legend of Grimrock, you know, works the same way. You have to go over here, you have to flip a switch and open this door so you can get out. It's a Skinner box. That's what it is in its basic form. But I'm trying to avoid doing that here. So let's bail out of that. I'm gonna see what a floor corpse looks like. And I probably still have to look through all the monsters as well. But, at least for here, it's going to be predominantly snails, because snails strike me as the kind of creatures that can just, they can eat rock, eat dirt. As opposed to, say, one of them flying birds that can, like, claw you and stuff. And I think I might have forgotten some. Nope, still there. I'll go ahead and I'll put the music back on. Okay, so that's what that looks like. So let me look and see if there's a skeleton. So, I guess I should have done this sooner. Yeah, no real way to make this work. So, I guess I'll just go ahead and shut the Twitch chat off. Oh, okay. So That's what that is. Floor corpse. Okay, so we got the corpse right there. And then... and then shield. So let's go kill that snail for that poor guy. All too late for him. Okay. So that... So that looks to be about... looks good on level one. Oh shoot, I totally forgot about this. Level two. Back up to level one. Coordinates on it. 31, 24. And then we got stairs up. Thank you. Let me preview it, make sure it's working properly. Oh shoot, I forget the name of it. Starting location. Okay, good. Okay, good. So it does know that. Okay, I see how that works now. Let me back that up. The direction this is facing here, that's where it's gonna take you next. So, yeah, stick a map marker. So I have to turn that then. And I believe that way. Okay, there we go. For here. Okay, now I'll start my usual RNG stuff. Just gotta find it. There it is. Discarding that one. Down. One. Discarding that. Left. Five. Up. Five. Left. Two. Down. Four. Gonna go ahead and discard that. Left. Three. Up. Six. Right. Three. Down. Down. Six. One, two, three. Down. Three. I'm trying to avoid duplicate rolls. Down. Five. Either two or four. Right, five. Discarding that. Left only, one. Same thing, left only, five. It's either gonna be upper left. Left, one. Up, four. Up again, five. Left, five. Up, one. Right, one. Down, three. Down again, four. Right, three. Map markers, I'm using those in case, so I don't get confused on where exactly along the length of cave I'm supposed to be starting from. I got a bad memory, so discarding that. Down. Four. and it's gonna be left only 6. Left again. And level 2, I'll go ahead and put the exit there. Those. And then some more snails. Put one right there. I'm trying to think. What would this guy have? Still thinking. So, if they don't have clubs in here, they gotta have blunt weapons in here. What else the hell are they called? Oh, cudgel. Oh, that's light armor. Those are gonna have to go. you have to have a, in order to wear light armor, you have to put points into light armor proficiency or something like that. So I guess I'll put in cloth. Oh, wait. Loincloth makes no sense. I'm trying to make this guy kind of a druid type. Druids usually wear leather, but like I said, you have to have a light armor proficiency in order to wear it. But if you're only on level 2, you're probably not high enough skill level in order to do that, so... I'll be shutting down soon, too. Probably once I get the monsters and stuff set up. Or get the corpses and the items and stuff. What's up, janitor? Just trying to make a dungeon. Oh, and in case you're curious about the music, it's Dungeon Master for the Super Nintendo. They don't have cloth armor in here, so I gotta find something else. Oh, peasant breeches, that's it. Peasant tunic. All these walls, they're basically generated randomly. All by dice roll. out of energy. Okay. Alright, looks like it checks out. So, Mr. Druid guy got killed by one of these snails. That's kind of the story behind this level. But like I was saying earlier, these floors, they're randomly generated. I'm doing everything by dice roll. Plus, they're basically constructed by snails, you know, using their slime to, you know, acidic slime to eat through the rock. So, I mean, they're animals, they have no intelligence, so there's no real set pattern here. Death by snail. Skip this. I'm gonna see what this cave-in looks like. Jesus. This guy can't hit the broadside of a barn. Turn. No. Never knew these things had a facing to them. like I said, I'm probably gonna be shutting down soon, too. Just probably long enough to make sure that this cave-in checks out. Really? Alrighty. Looks kind of silly, but... then. They definitely did this on the cheap. These. Add new item. Yep, poor Druid got killed by a snail. So that one's in the bag. Let me go ahead and save it. Next level. And I'm just... this next level I'm gonna make is just... gonna be the starting point for the where you start after you descend the stairs. One thirty-one. Perfect. Well, kill that. Okay, starting location. Let's get ready for a long trek. Okay, so I don't actually need to set a starting location then for the stairs transitions then. Okay. Oh. Alrighty. Now's about as good as time. I'm just gonna go ahead and shut her down. I gotta eat me some breakfast. Gotta hop in the shower yet. I still got some grocery shopping I gotta do, and my work week has started. So I won't be doing any morning stuff until next week. From here on out for the rest of this week, it's gonna be I'll be streaming Final Fantasy 14, usually anywhere between 4 to 6 p.m. U.S. Central Time. But aside from that, though, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. Appreciate it. And until next time, take care, all.